Well, hi guys, it's that time. It's our Bible teaching snippet of the day. Well, yesterday I took a little detour and I talked a little bit about how religion has kind of veered off of God's main big plan for man. And we kind of got stuck in the mud on this sin and repentance and going to hell or going to heaven and all. Now look, God does want us to repent. Repent means to change our mind and change our heart towards something. That means to change our heart toward our old life that we've lived and to change our heart toward Him, okay? So I'm not against repentance, okay? And I'm definitely not against people turning away from sin and getting it out of our lives. Jesus did not come so we could live in sin, but to free us from sin so we don't have to live in it any longer, okay? He saved us from sin. But let me get back to what I was saying. I told you about a friend that told me that she saw two different gods, that she saw this mean, angry, actually immature, whatever God in the Old Testament, and then in the New Testament you see Jesus and he's totally different. And I explained to you that it was about the covenants that God had with people and how he could deal with mankind according to his agreements with people. I do want to show you in the Bible, give you these two references. I said that Jesus said, and that the Bible says, so watch this, that he doesn't change. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. So he doesn't change. Jesus is God. All right, Malachi 3:6 says, this is God speaking. He says, I change not. So right there's an Old Testament and New Testament both saying that God stays the same. God doesn't change. His agreements and how he deals with people changes. Okay, now, I'm going to go back to what I was talking about, providing and protecting, because I want to make sure we nail this down, okay? God's plan was to always to provide a good future for man and to protect man from a bad end, and he's been doing that throughout the entire Bible. I can go back to Genesis chapter 10, that's the Tower of Babel. The people had become evil in their thinking and their faults, and God had to, he's already promised he's not going to do another flood, right? So he has to distribute everybody. He has to get them away from each other. He confuses their language and disperses the people on the earth so they'll get away from each other and not destroy themselves again. So we move forward to Genesis chapter 12, and this is where God calls Abram, who would become Abraham. On further out, we see where God works with Moses, and this is where I left off our last snippet, was how the Mosaic Law was put into place. And God used the Mosaic Law, here we go again, to protect man, really from each other, and to provide that Abrahamic bloodline a chance to get Jesus born into the earth. So see, God's provide and protect has not changed. I do want to talk about this Moses Law one more time, because we get so stinking confused in the church about this, okay? We think that this is some scroll we've got to unroll and live by. The Mosaic Law had 613 laws in it total. All we really know about, we don't even know and can recite the top 10, but what we know about is the 10. I want you to slow down and think about this. None of the top 10, the 10 commandments, has the word love in it, because God knew that man's fallen heart, his fallen nature, which was like Satan's nature, to steal, to kill, and to destroy each other and anything that got in our way out of our self-centeredness. None of that had the word love in it, because we as unrenewed people are not capable of loving other people the way we're supposed to. So God had to put the law in place to protect people from each other in their fallen nature. Jesus comes along in the New Testament and he says, a new command I give you. And his new command is called the law of love. Jesus says to love God and to love your neighbor as yourself. Okay, if I love God and I love my neighbor, or I love you, did you know if I keep those two commandments that Jesus gave me, the new ones, the law of love, I cannot break any of the Ten Commandments or even the 613, because if I have the right heart, love in my heart, I can't do any of those. because I love people. But watch this. I can keep every one of the Old Testament, the top 10 or the 613, and have hate in my heart and not love God and not love people. I just ain't broke none of the rules, guys, okay? So you see, when Jesus comes, we are able to die. Our old man dies, and a new man resurrects, and this new man has the true nature of God, which is love, agape love, toward him, toward God, and toward other people. And that's why Jesus said that he would write, and all through your Bible it talks about how God would write his laws on our heart. The only law he needs to write on our heart is love. Once we get that one thing right, where we love God and love people, then everything else falls into place. But here's the thing. Until you get born again and you get Jesus living in you, you're not going to be able to keep the two or the 613 or the 10. So let me say this. I want to wrap this little series up about God providing and protecting. God's plan from the beginning was to get Jesus born into this earth so that he could provide a good future for mankind and protect us from self-destruction from what we did in the Garden of Eden and renew us to be sons and daughters of God walking in the kingdom. It's right here, right now. Guys, Jesus would go everywhere and say, the kingdom of God has come near you. And then Jesus says, the kingdom of God is in you. Did you know when I walk into a place, a son of God just walked in, and I can look at those people, any of them, and say, the kingdom of God has come near you because it's in me. And because I have the Holy Spirit and the power of the Holy Spirit in me working actively, I can do those same miracles that Jesus did, just like he asked me to do. Well, that's going to be a wrap-up on our little series that I've been doing on providing and protecting, and I hope that I've enlightened you and shown you some things that you didn't know before. I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to surprise you with tomorrow, but it's pretty good. I love you guys, and I'll see you again right here on Facebook. Bye-bye.